You are damn right that I'm playing this song. Sonny, you're right, mate. Are you alive after that? 3-1! give it to me. Oh, that's beautiful. What a beautiful, beautiful result. I'm going to keep talking over this song. I'm not really, because I'm just going to keep shouting. Man United, 3-1 winners there against Spurs. And fuck you, Son. Screw you, Jose. Spurs tried it, but United blew them away in that second half. That first half, it was a goal for United. That is a travesty of VAR. Son actually tried to pull McTominay after he skipped past him. McTominay sort of, in a natural reaction, I would say, just palmed him off because Son tried to pull him. Son went down like someone had shot him. The stretcher came on. And the goal was disallowed. Ridiculous. And of course, 2 minutes later, Spurs and Son scored. And given what happened in the 6-1 early this season with Lamella when he hit Martial in the face first before Martial got sent off, Solskjaer was pissed on the side of the pitch. And United at that point could have gone within themselves. But we didn't. Fred scored. Cavani scored. And Greenwood scored. United 3-1 winners there. And that tastes good. That tastes really, really good. After the 6-1 earlier this season, Ole Gunnar Solskjaer really would have wanted that from his team. And United delivered today. United have built the reputation this season of being pretty crap in the first half away from home and pretty fantastic in the second half. And today we did the exact same thing, but we did not just beat Spurs in that second half. We absolutely systematically destroyed them. Paul Pogba, influential at both ends of the pitch. Edinson Cavani showing again why he's going to be a miss. When he apparently he's going to go Boca Juniors this season in the summer. We're going to miss him. It's such a rounded striker. But Mason Greenwood's development. Oh, my, there's so many talking points. Who's your man of the match? Probably I'm going to have to go for Cavani. But from what that could have been to what that's turned out to be, that's brilliant. That's glorious. Because it was shithousery of the highest order what Son did. He cheated. No two ways about it. He cheated. He got beaten by McTominay and he went down holding his face and stayed down. Ridiculous decision that got overturned, but that's what VAR is. Every single game week, it seems, some mad decision happens. And United could have, yeah, United were pissed off about that. United were pissed. And we could have gone the other way. But if there's one thing that United have shown this season, it's having fight and determination to get back into the game. And we did that in abundance in that second half. Let me know what your reaction is to that game there, but Man United, as far as I'm concerned, even before that game, we'd secured top four this season. And now we've certainly secured top four. As far as I'm concerned anyway, it's all about the Europa League now. But that game in itself was, it just sums up United's season. The first half, the tempo wasn't there. Marcus Rashford, again, he looks like a shell of himself. He's knackered. He's absolutely knackered. And he's not playing like he can play. But still, he's involved in moments. And that goal that was disallowed should not have been disallowed. It was beautiful. And Fred's equaliser, the wonderful, quick interplay that United had on the edge of the box there. And Rashford was part of that. There are so many damn talking points in that game. And in a good way. And as I said, the 6-1 defeat scarred Solskjaer. And that's going to be a result that he, as a manager, will never, ever forget. And that's no surprise that we saw Fred and McTominay starting today. And Fred and McTominay controlled the middle of that pitch. They are brilliant together when they work together. Fred, he's done that a lot this season. Fred's had like an abysmal first half and then a brilliant second half. He, more than most, just embodies that second half surge that United seem to have. But it's kind of, it's verging on ridiculous now. But in the same way that under Fergie, United, it wasn't just coincidence that we scored late goals. It was a habit that we built. And this now is completely a habit that this Solskjaer's team has built. Whenever we're 1-0 down, whenever we're having a bad first half, do not rule United out, because odds are we are going to improve and we are going to get better in that second half. And United did it today. And we destroyed Spurs in that second half. And it was so, so sweet to see that. after what happened with Son, because that could have been the talking point. And I think that's the problem with VAR, why so many people are frustrated about it, because unfortunately it is the controversial talking point. After a football match, you should be talking about the football instead of the refereeing decisions, the on the pitch decision. It's all a bit of a shambles. And that could have been the talking point today. But United, instead of doing that, have turned that into a wonderful 3-1 victory, which really, hopefully, can... Well, we don't need that much momentum. Granada 2-0, we didn't really get out of second gear. I mean, that should be the same thing in the second leg. Semi-finals, I think we play Ajax against Roma. That would be tougher. But United... It's all about, it's very important for United to finish this season on a high and to keep progressing upwards. And today, that game against Jose Mourinho, against Tottenham Hotspur, after the 6-1 early this season, and in the context of the game of what happened with Son, with McTominay getting that foul, and then Son scoring 2 minutes later, it just could have been another one of those days where you come away frustrated and come away angry at decisions that went against you. But instead, United turned that and used that for the fuel to the fire for that second half performance. And I've got to talk about Mason Greenwood, because Mason Greenwood, for me, has really developed this season. You know, when he burst onto the scene, he was just an incredible goal scorer. Incredible goal scorer. And that hasn't changed. But something that you're really seeing from Mason is his all-round game is improving and getting better. And that cross for Cavani's goal, first time, little perfect cross on his left foot. Cavani, great header from him. But Greenwood, he wouldn't have done that last season, I don't think. And then for the goal itself, great movement on the right foot, left foot, right foot, mate. Mason Greenwood, maybe when Cavani leaves this summer, maybe we don't manage to sign Haaland or any striker that we're going to sign, and maybe we'll see a lot more of Mason Greenwood through the middle. And I would not be adverse to that. But right now, he's the best we've got out on that right wing. I thought Aaron Wan-Bissaka had a good game. I thought Victor Lindelof was a bit unfortunate. He was certainly at fault for the goal, but he wasn't the only one at fault. He was kind of like off balance when he kicked air, when the ball went through him, and then Kane squared it for Son. But our whole defence was semi out of position at that point. I'm reveling in how that turned out. From where it was to where it ended, it could have been so different. It could have been a very mundane match reaction. Instead, you got me singing. And that's always a good sign, even if I haven't had a haircut in a while. Although apparently my hair doesn't look that bad, although I really want a haircut. That's besides the point. But I'm just loving it. I'm really soaking up that wing. I said it to you in the last game against Granada. It's very hard to get excited, really, about football these days, because it's just tepid. Without the fans in the stadiums, it's a lukewarm atmosphere at best. But today, the controversy was the spice, the salt and pepper on that game that we needed. And with that extra bit of seasoning, you had a bit more involvement in the game. And to have gone from that with Son, that disgraceful bit of cheating, to that turnaround in that second half, and Fred scoring, Cavani scoring after his first goal was ruled out. And what a goal that was. Pogba through the legs. Oh, Cavani, lovely finish through the legs. Oh, delicious goal. Ruled out. For him to have scored that, you saw what it meant to him in that celebration. And then Greenwood right at the end. Put that in your pipe and smoke it. United 3-1 winners there against Spurs. I'm a bit happy, actually. I think you can tell that. Let me know what your reaction is in the comments below. Who was your man of the match for me? I can't look past Edinson Cavani. Not only was he just involved everywhere. He was involved everywhere in terms of the goals. He got that goal that was wrongly disallowed. He got the second goal and was involved in all of it. And he was involved in that. Was it dinked it just out, I think, came off Pogba's head. Then Cavani dinked it onto the post and where Sissoko was going to knock it in. Look, Henderson as well, by the way. Jeez, I should mention him. That was a very, very good performance from Henderson. I kept hearing his shouts. I kept hearing his commands. He was in the right place at the right time. He nearly even got saved Son's goal. Very powerful performance from Henderson there in a game where we needed a powerful goalkeeper. All credit to him. But who was your man of the match? What's your reaction after that? Can somebody do me a favour and just let me know when Son's funeral is, so I can send some money and some condolences over, because obviously it was horrible what happened to him on the pitch today. No one likes to see it. You know, as football fans, we have to unite and sort of pray for Son, because it was horrible what happened to him. 3-1. That's it. 3-1.
Unlucky Jose. Unlucky Son. See you next time.